The Delta II Max is a powerful, affordable power station with a ton of plug options. It's been out for almost 2 years, and EcoFlow has continued to move forwards with units like the Delta III Plus. So the real question is, 2 years later, is this still something that you should spend your money on? So welcome back to the lab, where our opinions cannot be bought. When the Delta II Max released, it was EcoFlow's mightiest Delta unit below the Delta Pro lineup. And that still kind of stands true today. So we've put it through a bunch of testing and spent some time with it here at the lab to help you guys decide if this unit might be the one that you're looking for. But before we share with you guys everything that we liked and didn't like about the Delta II Max, we'll leave down below any coupons that we can squeeze out of EcoFlow. We also have information on this month's giveaway. Make sure you guys subscribe if you haven't done one of the million other things I've already told you to do. And before we get into it, we're gonna give you guys a super quick spec teardown to get you up to speed on the Delta II Max. So first up, this passes the tiny baby lift test. It only weighs about 50 pounds. He could curl two of these at the same time. It's a 2048 watt hour battery bank with a 2400 watt inverter. In terms of getting power into this guy, you can plug it into a regular 120 volt wall outlet in your house and charge it up to 1800 watts. You can also charge this with solar, and it has a 1000 watt solar input, which means you could basically charge it in about 2 hours just off solar panels alone, which is not bad. And when it comes to ports and plugs on this guy, on the front, you have four USB-A's and you have two USB-C's. The two USB-C's are 100 watts, which is pretty good. And two of these USB-A's are labeled as fast charging. Not more specific than fast charging, but fast charging. On the side, you have your two expansion battery ports because this unit is expandable up to just over 6,000 watt hours with two expansion batteries. And then on the back side, you have your 620 volt wall outlets, which is fire. Way too many wall outlets. Underneath this little flap, you have your AC input, you have your two solar inputs, and you have a 12 volt. Holy shit.
Yeah, that's what I was saying earlier. It's in there. Oh, that was like a 12 volt
car socket.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
You have your 12 volt car socket and two barrel connectors. Otherwise, the design is relatively similar to all of EcoFlow's older products. This is what they basically all looked like. You have your fans coming in on both sides. Plastics are pretty good. They're actually solid. There's no real squishy spots on this thing. Nice handles. You got a rubber ring around the top to support your expansion batteries. You got the rubber feet on the bottom to support your unit. Overall, it's pretty good. The screen is crisp and clear and bright, thankfully. It looks just like every other EcoFlow screen, nice and simple, doesn't show you anything you don't need to know. And EcoFlow's app is still one of the better apps that's out there. It lets you control a bunch of stuff from the app that you can't necessarily do from the unit, and it just lets you turn things on and off from afar. Works really well. And right now, you can get this thing with our discount code for $1,044. The first thing that we like about the Delta II Max is that it still performs really well. The UPS works, the solar input works, everything works with this guy, and it was really good in efficiency and idle consumption. The efficiency on this was about 86%, which means when you're running it from full to empty, the inverter and the fans and all that aren't consuming a ton of power, and the idle consumption on this was 13.6 watts per hour, which basically means if you just turn on the AC inverter on the back, and let it run. Maybe you're powering a sump pump, comes on every once in a while, but it's not always on. And the unit's just sitting there idling with the AC inverter on. It'll last over 6 days just doing nothing, which is really good. A lot of units struggle to last 2 days. So 6 days is honestly like, that's a thumbs up. Good job to EcoFlow for that. The Anker F3800 for reference has like an 80 watt idle consumption. We also really like how many plugs you get for a unit of this size. And how much better the plugs are than like the Delta II. So you get six 120 volt plugs, which is really good. It lets you plug in all kinds of stuff, and they're all grounded. So the Delta II, the smaller like original version of this, doesn't have the grounded plugs, which could be fine for you. In my case, I hate that. It drives me nuts. I always have things with ground plugs. So the fact that there's six of these is just cool. You can help power a million different things. We also like that the plugs are on the front and back only. So you can push this up against a wall or throw it in a vehicle, or if you just need the AC plugs or just need the USB plugs, you can push it right in the back of your car, stack stuff all over it, and you still have access to your plugs, which is nice. We also really like how expandable this unit is for a cheaper, more entry-level unit. You can expand this thing up to just over 6,000 watt hours, which is pretty good. You could buy one now if that's what you can afford. And as your demand grows, as your life grows, you can grow with this unit. You don't need to sell it and buy another one. Companies like Jackery just pick and choose which units get expansion batteries. I like the EcoFlow gives you that option. We also like that it's quiet. A lot of older EcoFlow units were not quiet. And so the fact that this one is still older, but is also really quiet is really nice because they've done a really good job on all of their new power stations. Anything silver is basically dead silent. So the fact that they were getting there with this one before they redesigned is cool. So if you had a power outage and you were running this in your house, or you were camping and you had it in your tent or something like that, it wouldn't bug you. It's not dramatically loud. Now, speaking of camping and doing the fun things in life, we also really like how EcoFlow's alternator charger would pair perfectly with something like this. We don't talk about this guy a lot. We installed it, made a video on it. This thing will take the extra power from your alternator while you're driving and charge your unit at 800 watts. They also released a new 500 watt version if you want to save like a minuscule amount of money. I don't really get why they did it. Just buy the 800 watt one. It's better. Purchase. If you do any kind of camping or overlanding, this thing is like solid metal. It's really well built, super easy to install, and it just makes sense, especially with a unit like this. You could charge this thing up in like just about 2 hours of driving around. So if you're driving from here to go camping, you could leave with this dead, assuming you're not camping at the neighbor's house.
The quality of that thing is like awesome.
Yeah, these are good. Okay, good job. We like this. And something kind of unique to this unit is like the rubber feet underneath also wrap around the edges, which is kind of nice. So if you're gonna put this, not only will it like sit on the table like this and be hard to move, it just doesn't slide around. If you're gonna put this in your car or on a table, if you come up short and you smack it off the edge, you're not hitting hard plastic off of something. You're not gonna scratch your car or mess up your table. It's got a nice little rubber cushiony chin here so you can bounce it off things, which we like. You don't really see that too often. It's cool. When it comes to things that we don't like about this guy, the first one, if you guys have watched any EcoFlow video on our channel before, you should already know X-Boost is fake. They always advertise X-Boost on this. It's a 2400 watt inverter. And I think the X-Boost they say is like 3600 watts, but it doesn't actually, like all X-Boost does is pull voltage. We made an entire video on it. Never buy an EcoFlow product based off what the X-Boost says. That's wrong. Just go off the inverter size. X-Boost, no bueno. This unit also doesn't really surge at all. EcoFlow has a tendency to say their units will surge really well and they kind of don't. Great example, Delta Pro Ultra, their biggest unit, Anker F3800, close competitor. The F3800 will surge to start much bigger loads than the Delta Pro Ultra, even though the Delta Pro Ultra is on paper the bigger unit. And that holds true all the way down EcoFlow's lineup. This thing doesn't really surge too well, so just know that. And the last thing that we don't like, especially with a unit of this size, that's like heavy enough you need two hands to pick it up, there's no light. Come on, give us a light. EcoFlow, I know it's a long time ago, but can we just start getting lights on units? Because especially this thing is 50 pounds, you're not gonna one hand it around. If you have a power outage or you're camping, you're just inflating an air mattress in your tent, a light on here will genuinely make your life better. So EcoFlow, stop watching these videos and not putting lights on before we f- So the answer is, in 2025, this is still something I would reach for. I would recommend it to a friend. I would genuinely take this with me and use it on camping trips, or even in small emergency situations where the power's out at the home. This is still a great unit. It performed well. We are happy with it here at the lab. And we think it's still worth your money. And honestly, it's still a pretty good deal, even in 2025. So that's pretty much all we got for you guys today. Make sure you go in the description down below and check out information on this month's giveaway, as well as any coupon codes. That is all we got for you guys. I will catch you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.